there are plenty of perks of being over 60, aren't there, ladies?
Oh, yeah, you're fantastic. Still here. It's very important. Oh.
Well, we get a half-price ticket to the movies on Tuesday. And the other thing is, you know, when you say you've got a pain here, they believe you. And they're very easy to give you a steroid injection.
And we know when to shove. And we know when to shove off.
Oh, I like it. Well, there is also the ability to laugh at life like they did on the TV show The Golden Girls. Take a look.
When you're 20, no matter what you do, everything stays where it's supposed to. Now, when you lean over, it looks like somebody's let the air out of your face. Honey, lean over a mirror sometime and take a look at yourself.
Where's a mirror? There's one in the tool drawer.
I think you better take a sedative before you look.
Don't be silly. I look at my face all the time. How different could it be leaning over? Oh, my God! Oh, my God, Dorothy, why didn't you tell me about this before?
Only on your back, Blanche. That way everything slides back and you look like you just had a facelift.
Well, joining us today to celebrate life after 60 is Kaylee Harris from the 50 Up Club and the new Talking Lifestyle Radio Network. Kaylee, welcome to Studio 10.
Thank you, Sarah.
Very funny clip that we just saw from the Golden Girls, but what are some of the biggest challenges that people over 60 face?
I think one of the challenges is relevance. I think when we get over 50 and over 60, advertisers stop noticing us more, and we find that a lot of the advertising to our demographic is either erectile dysfunction or funeral homes, those sorts of things, and retirement packages. Whereas we really, you know, we're just at the beginning of our lives.
When you're, well, aren't they ridiculous? You look at the market they miss all the time. I mean, it's a fact that older women spend more on cosmetics and hair care than the younger demographic. That is a fact. We also buy lots of things for our children and our grandchildren. We're a very important market and we're overlooked constantly. I think advertisers really miss the boat when it comes to the older end of the market.
Generally, when you see advertising for older people, it's usually a heterosexual couple. They're white, they've got perfectly coughed grey hair, and they're sitting behind the steering wheel of a yacht. Now, that's not reality, you know. That's not how most of us are living our lives, and I think it just...
I cover up my grey.
Oh, so do I. Don't worry.
Who doesn't? And they're always a couple. They're always a couple.
They're always a couple.
And yet, as far as women are concerned, many of us live our lives alone. And we're never...
We're alone, man. We like it.
That's it.
You got it.
What was the biggest change for you, Denise, after turning 60?
I had really, really good health, in fact, up to 65. Wow. Didn't have one problem, and then all of a sudden it just went like that. And now I had pains in legs, head, everything. It was just like the body went, oh, I'm a bit tired. And so, but now I'm fine. I got over all of that, and now this year's been fantastic. So I think maybe you have to go through that to get to the other side.
Yeah.
But don't give in.
No, that's right. It's the age of agelessness, I think, that your body might be changing, but mentally you still, you know, feel young and you're still who you are.
Did you see that pill that's going to... They gave it to rats.
The anti-aging pill.
They gave it to rats?
Yep.
They'll give it to me.
And the scientists are so thrilled they're all taking it. I was 63 when I paid my first visit to a gym. I'd never been to a gym until I turned 63. And what I discovered was that, A, I was fitter than most of the younger people in the gym, and also that I could push myself further than I thought. So I think what happens as we get older is that we actually put brakes on ourselves. And what I've learned is that there's no need to put a brake on yourself. You just keep doing things. And I really loved the gym, and I did all sorts of things that I would never have thought in a month of Sundays. Taken up Pilates.
Twice a week.
And I was the girl that used to get her mother to write a note to get me out of physical education classes. So look how I've changed.
Do you find, Ita, because you do a lot of campaigning for rights of older people, were you treated vastly differently after 60? Did you feel that you were treated negatively? Maybe spoken
down
to? No,
and I think it's very difficult for me to answer that because I have a very high public profile. I mean, there is no getting away from it, I do. And therefore, no, I didn't feel I was treated any differently. I think, I'm much older than 60 now, And I think, you know...
I know that.
I think you're very conscious... I know, darling. Don't look down, remember.
And I think people are very respectful now. You know, there's a different way that people treat you. It's just, you're just conscious of it. But, you know, we talk about things dropping. It was a really eye-opening thing. Now, somewhere in my 60s, I was getting something altered. And the dressmaker's going behind me. She's behind me. And I said, what are you doing? She said, I'm just checking your elbows haven't dropped. And you think, oh, God.
Drop?
Yes, apparently they do. I know it's a... I think they're all right.
Carol, I've got that bit, though. See well, that? That's my dad's elbow.
It's very cool.
Hereditary.
Ooh.
Is that funny? No, it's just double bones. Ugly, I would have said.
Not
but anyway.
It does seem as though... I don't know. My mother-in-law is... just over 60, sorry, Annie. But she has stamina like these girls. You know, she's off at the gym every day. She's running around between all of us kids looking after grandchildren. She has more energy than all of her sons put together. There seems to have been a big shift once people, you know, get past 60. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, definitely. I think that there's a tendency for society to want us to contract. And to you feel like you become invisible when you get over 50 or over 60, that people don't see you anymore. And I think for our generation, for baby boomers, people in their 50s and 60s now, we're coming through and we're in uncharted waters. You know, we're not the same as our parents. I have an 82-year-old mother living with me. And when you talk about 50, people who are over 50, we're all lumped into the same demographic. So I'm in the same demographic as my mother. Mm. Whereas when you look at younger demographics, there's 10 to 17s, 18 to 24s, 24 to 39s. You get to 50, you're all of those people. And when you get to 80, there's so little research done on people who are over 80 because nobody really wants to market to them or research to them. So I think now that baby boomers are coming into their 50s and 60s, we don't want to, you know, contract and sit back and decline. We actually want to go out there and, as Ida said, well, is go out there and reinvent yourself.
It's always been predicted that the baby boomers would change the whole the whole idea of ageing. They would want it a different way. You know,
yes,
they want
definitely.
Different kinds of retirement homes. I mean, everything about the baby boomers, they want difference. They've always pushed for change, and they're pushing for change now that they're older.
Yeah, and we want to have a voice as well. We not just want to have a voice socially, but economically we have a voice, and we're a force to be reckoned with when it comes to marketers. So with the work that I do with the 50 Up Club, we all join together as people power, and we go out there and say to advertisers, hey, we're here, we've got money to spend, don't neglect us, don't treat us like we don't exist.
And Ida and I can do their ads.
Definitely.
No problem.
You'll be there.
We can catch Hayley on the Daily Drive show on the Talking Lifestyle Radio Network. Hayley Harris, thank you so much for joining us on the couch.